Hi, I'm Jesse with Metroline Direct. In this video, I will be showing you an overview of the Avaya B199 conference phone. It's a SIP-based VoIP gigabit Ethernet phone, and of course it is still backward compatible with the older 10/100 megabit per second ports, in case you were wondering. Although it's SIP-based, it does register with your system using an Avaya endpoint license. Officially, Avaya is saying 10.1.0.6 or higher, or 11.0.4.2 or higher, but I did test it on my test system with 11.0.4.1, and it does still use an Avaya endpoint license, and it seemed to work fine for me. So just fair warning, if you do use it with an older system release, it can still register to your system, but it will use a third-party endpoint license instead of the Avaya endpoint license. And it can also be expanded with two smart microphones or daisy-chained with two other phones. The total devices would have to be three devices though, so you could have one other microphone and one other phone, or you know, just whatever combination of three devices that you want. And another cool feature is that there's an app that you can use to control the phone from your smartphone. You can use it on your Android or iOS smartphone. And we'll take a look at that in a second here. Let's go take a look. So it has a GUI web browser interface. You can put in the IP address of the phone, and you will need to include https://... at the beginning. Otherwise it will reject your connection. And here's the status of my screen. It's going to show you all the pertinent information about your phone. You'll notice on the upper right corner here it says it's registered. I can click on the basic tab at the top and I can name my phone, change the ring level, reboot the device. The SIP tab is where you'll put in the information for your specific phone's extension. And you can have a secondary and fallback account on here as well if you'd like. Okay, so we can see we have a few different options on the display here. We've got call if we want to manually call a phone number, recent if we want to use the call log, conference assistant, which we will get into in a minute. So let's call another extension. And now we can see we can add up to three more participants. So the thing to remember here is that this conference phone will use its own resources to conference these callers together instead of using the system resources, which means that if you need to add more than four participants to your conference call, you'll need to use a conference bridge. So let's go ahead and add someone. And this time we'll use the call log. So now you can see you have the first call on hold, and the second call is the one that you're talking to. So if I want to join these two together, I can hit the conference button at the bottom. Now I can see they're both joined together. If I want to talk privately with one of them, I can tap that. I can either talk privately to them, or I can put them on hold and talk to the rest of the conference. So now I'm just talking privately with that caller. And then if I want to join them back together, I can hit conference at the bottom again. I can also disconnect one of the callers if I want. And then I can hang up on the conference call. So now let's look at the conference assistant. If you have NFC turned on your phone, you can use the NFC function. At the bottom of the phone, you can see the NFC icon. And you can just hold the middle part of your phone over that icon, and it will automatically take you to your app store, and then you'll see you have Avaya Conference Assistant, and I'll hit install. If you don't have NFC turned on your phone, you can always manually search for Avaya Conference Assistant in your app store. It will open up to a tutorial, and I'll go ahead and skip that for right now. It's going to ask you if you want to allow Conference Assistant to access your contacts. It's up to you, but you can use your contacts on your personal phone to make phone calls, and I'll show you a little bit of that later. You can also allow it to access your calendar. Then you can use the calendar to set up meetings and call into your conference bridge or whatever phone number you have to call. So I'll go ahead and hit allow. And it also wants to access the device's location. I didn't get into using any of the features that use the device's location, but I'll go ahead and allow it here anyway. And now it's asking me to connect to conference phone 441. That's what I have my phone labeled as, conference phone 441. I'll go ahead and hit connect. And then it will give me a one-time PIN number that I'll have to enter in. So the first thing you see is today's agenda. This is showing me what I have entered in on my calendar. See at the bottom we're on the calendar tab. You can see it says two participants. It's just showing that because I've entered in someone's email address into my calendar. It's counting me and that participant. But I can tap that and you can see it shows phone and then I have the phone number and then PIN. So I'll go ahead and touch the join by conference phone button. And it will automatically dial that for me.
Please enter your PIN file. Thank you. You are the only participant in the conference.
So let's take a look at the conference bridge now. In settings, so I can come to the My Bridge section and enter in the phone number of my favorite conference bridge. And even if I have the use prefix entered in up here, I notice that I did still have to enter it in down here. So now I can hit the left arrow button at the top. On the calendar tab, I can hit this icon that looks like three people. That's called the My Bridge button. And it automatically dials
Welcome
my bridge.
Welcome and thank you for...
Okay, so now I'm going to show you how to make a phone call using your contacts on your cell phone. So first, let's go back to Settings. Go down to Use Prefix. And remember, on my system, I use 8 to dial out. So I'll put an 8 in there. Go back. And then I'm going to go to Contacts at the bottom. And let's call Chris.
Hello, this is Chris.
Hey, Chris, how's it going?
I'm good. How are you doing?
Good. Hey, I'm just testing out the Avaya B199 conference phone here. I just want to make sure everything's sounding really good and clear.
Yep, sounds good.
Cool. And while we're on the phone here, I just want to point out we've got the same controls on the phone, on the smartphone as you do on your main phone. You can turn the volume up, turn it down. You've got your mute button. You can see it automatically mutes on the phone. We can put the call on hold, add another participant if we want to, and of course hang up the call. Hey, Chris, I appreciate everything. You take care. Have a good night.
Yep, you too.
One more thing I did want to mention. There's a group function built into the Avaya Conference Assistant app, which is supposed to allow you to call a group of phone numbers. I tried out the feature on several different software and firmware versions, and personally, I was not able to get it working. If you've been able to get it working, let me know. That's our video for today. Let me know if you liked the video by clicking the like button. That also helps us out, and say hi in the comments. Thanks for watching.